Alright guys, welcome back to another video on the channel. Today's video I'm going to be showing you a cool little trick you can do with command blocks. And if you're ever making any kind of map or just a little area for you and your friends to play around with, then this command can come in very helpful. As you can see here, we've got the arena, but we've also got some kit boxes. So we've got kit 1, kit 3, wait no, kit 1, kit 2, and kit 3. So all these kits, you know, they look good, but they've only got one set of armor in them, so they're gonna run out and you're gonna have to keep replenishing them. Well, check this out. Instantly regenerates back. I take it all out. I've still got the armor in my inventory and it instantly regenerates back, so I can put all this armor on as well. And then I can, you know, get some more for my friend or my opponent and they can wear some as well. So boom. So if you're wondering how I did this, I'm going to show you the command I used. And by the way, just so you know, it does work on all the other ones as well. So on kit 2 it works too. So as you can see, it will regenerate, and on kit 3, it will regenerate as well. So that's very cool. So I'm just going to show you now how I did this and how you can do it on your own world too. So basically guys, what you're going to need is the block on the floor to just cover it up. You're going to need a command block. You can either have a shulker box or a chest, and then you'll finally need a slab of any sort, preferably matching the one of the floor which you're building with. So basically you just want to place a shulker box there for reference and dig 1, 2, 3 blocks down. So we have the shulker box, then we want to count 1 block, 2 blocks below, break that, and then break the block just below that. So in this block right at the bottom, we're going to place a command block. So in the settings here, you want to make the block type true repeat. Needs redstone? Nope. Always active. Then delay and ticks. This can be whatever you want, but I recommend having something above 40, because if it's below 40, it tend to glitch sometimes and not work very well. So I'm going to go for 50, which is what I used on my example. And then we're going to exit out of that. And we're just going to place a nice little shulker box here. So obviously we can't open it, so that's why I need the slab. So you're going to break this, and then instead crouch and place a slab, so we can actually open it. So this will work with chests as well, so boom, but normally you wouldn't. But if we do the slab, it will still work, and you'll be able to open it. So we want to go into the command block and type the following command. So you want to type the word clone, space, then do a tilde. This should be in the symbols section. On iOS, on Android, should be the same, but I don't know the exact whereabouts. So you do clone, then you want to put a space and do a tilde, like so. Then another space, tilde, then 1, then another space, then 3 tildes, then a 1 again, then another space, and then you do 3 more tildes, then a 3, and 1 more tilde after that 3. So now, we will see that every 50 ticks, it will replace the block here, no matter what it is. It could be a white shulker. It will replace it with the new chest down here. So if I put a shulker instead, it will replace the chest with, you know, the shulker. So if I have nothing, it will replace it with nothing. If I have just air and put that there, it will still replace it. So now this can be used to essentially put whatever you want in the shulker. So let's say I'm making a sort of kit like I did before for PvP. Now I'd put my items inside this shulker or this chest, then the one above it would put the items back in. So even if I take it out, it'd regen it and put the items back inside. So then you can just cover it up and you've got a fully working sort of kit box. And you can do this so that when people are on a map, like a PvP map, they don't have to keep, it's just easier to get their armor back after it breaks or whatever. So you can also put a sign on it as well, and the sign will stay there, it won't go away. It won't like break, because it doesn't actually break the block, it just replaces it, so the sign won't ever fall. Because normally if I just break the block, the sign will fall. However, it just replaces it, so even after every tick, the sign will still stay there. So that is pretty much it. If you have any extra questions on how this works or you're struggling with something, then just comment down below and I'll be happy to help out. Anyways, that's all for me today. I'll see you guys later. Bye.